Good afternoon. So I'll try to draw your attention during the next couple of minutes about few examples of Moldova using non-invasive methods together with the colleagues from Romania and Germany. So few words about international rules. So I will not talk so much about, because most of you know exactly what the international conventions or recommendations required on to use more or less non-invasive methodology. But since 1956, each international document is trying to ask us to be more, or to be more careful, to pay more attention to archaeological tools. So the non-invasive methods in Moldova starts a couple of decades ago. In 1974, for the first time, Dudkin tried to use the first magnetometer in the, one of the well-known prehistoric site, Petrin, which is from Cucutin Tripoli culture, and using different aerophotography, but also the first magnetometer to try to establish the structure of the prehistoric settlement. So we have the first pictures from this time. But a few years ago, together with the German colleagues, we tried to use new tools to discover the real structure of the settlements, and of course to know more better about the dwelling plans, about the whole structure of the Petrin and other prehistoric sites from Republic of Moldova. So in 2005, it was the first, let's say, intervention of the new magnetometer, but one channel in the bronze site, but without any so much and so good results. Later on in 2009, together with colleagues from the Römisch Germanische Kommission aus Frankfurt am Main, so we tried to use this five-channel census magnetometer in different sites. And then later we invited the colleagues from Iași University, because they have more tools using the GPR or other tools in different sites. So now a few results. In 2009, we tried to use this five-channel magnetometer in various antique, so Iron Age and prehistoric sites. So the best results comes from the prehistoric, from Cucutien Tripoli culture, probably because this special dwelling and platforms which are more or better visible on the plans. So you could see now the just small part of surveys from 2009 in Petrin. Later on, or one year later, the German colleagues came to Moldova of 16 channel, which is much easier, because usually the prehistoric sites are very huge, more than 15 or 20 hectares, and of course of these five channels took a lot of time. So we tried to use 16 channel magnetometer, which is much easier, and in 1-2 days we could cover surface of 20 hectares of each settlement, and we succeed. So one example is from Singeri. Also, it's most of them are placed in the north of Republic of Moldova, and you could see the results which show us the much better the structure of Cucutien Tripoli site. So the focused on, you could see the dwellings. And we came back to the Petrin, because Petrin site, it's known from 19th century that done some archaeological excavations, but also survey, because it's one of the biggest settlement, Cucutien Tripoli settlement from the Republic of Moldova, among other settlements in this part of Europe. So during the next years, we try to cover the whole area of this settlement. So you could see the dwellings, how they are oriented, organized. It's very well organized settlement. So at the end, we try to combine this picture to try to understand the structure of the settlement, different groups of dwellings, maybe streets, maybe other complexes. So in finally, we did the structure, and now the work is under print, and I hope in a few months you'll get it and you'll understand exactly what we have done, or more details about this. But what exactly, so I can show you the picture of this, exactly how we established the structure of this Neolithic settlement from Republic of Moldova, in comparison, of course, of other settlements from Ukraine, Romania, and other parts of this Cucutien Neolithic culture, and of course the platforms of the dwellings from this 4-3 millennium settlement from the Republic of Moldova. So another example comes from Orhei Vek. It's in middle part of Republic of Moldova. During last 10 years, we are trying to apply for UNESCO World Heritage List of this site. So this is already nominated. Probably this year will be evaluated and discussed more by UNESCO experts and ICOMOS experts. So preparing the dossier, of course, we try to use different methods to be more, to try to describe better the situation of Old Orhei, because it's original landscape, two canyons or one canyon done by this small river, Reut River. And of course, we try to use different maps, historic maps, old maps, new maps. We try to do new topography using new tools, of course. And this is just general one to see different places, historic places in Old Orhei since prehistoric time. But most of them are coming from Iron Ages and, of course, Middle Ages, including a couple of important sites from Mongolian Tatar period, Golden Horde period. We have three baths or remains of three baths. We have one fortress. We have a lot of coins from this 13th, 14th century. From Tatar period, which is very impressive. And of course, later on, the Moldovan site during the medieval times of 14th, 15th, 16th century. What exactly we try to do? Of course, to use magnetometry to understand better the structure. But unfortunately, we try to do in different parts of the site to understand also or to discover the structure. But unfortunately, the results are not so good. So you could see the difference of surveyed on the prehistoric sites and medieval and Iron Age sites. So the results are not so well like previous one. Of course, in some cases, we have the remains of the dwelling or some constructions from the medieval time, but not like previous one. Together with the colleagues from the United States, of course, we try to use LIDAR methodology to understand better the structure or to describe better the situation in Orhei Vek, not just because of original landscape, but also to focus more on the remains from different periods. We try to put on the map already known sites, already known constructions from the various periods. And the surprise was to discover a new hill fort from Iron Age. We suppose that we know everything from Orhei Vek because it's a well-known sign. And after Second World War, excavations and different various archaeological surveys have been done. But according to the LIDAR pictures, we discovered, and you could see on this area, a new Iron Age hill fort. So we have one here, another one in this area. This one, it's known, but we try to focus more and to understand the structure. But this is really new one of three waves and ditches, like in other part of Republic of Moldova from Iron Age. So you could see that the LIDAR, it's useful even in the sites which we consider that we know very well. So another pictures from Orhei Vek of this profile line, which are showing that's the real hill fort in this area. Why we didn't pay so much attention before? Because it's not the forest, but vegetation. It's really, so let's say middle vegetation it is. And every day we are crossing the area, but we didn't see the remains of hill fort. And just by the LIDAR picture, now we, of course, will try to focus more on this area. And the last, okay, not the last, but the last example in my presentation, it's about the project done together with the German colleagues, landscape archaeology in Cubolta Valley, which is very small river, but on both sides of the river, we have a lot of different archaeological settlements from various periods of times, from the prehistoric, from the Bronze Age, and from the late antiquity, and we try to analyze, to discuss, to do the surveys among the river, and we stopped on a settlement from the late antiquity, and to try to use also magnetometry and other methods to understand the structure of this site, because previous we tried to use the magnetometer in other sites, and unfortunately the picture are not so well. In finally, last year, we succeed with the magnetometer in this site, and we could see the structure of the settlement from the late antiquity, 3-4 century. So we use also the drone to build the picture of the settlement to understand better the landscape. And also we use various tools, not just magnetometer of the fine channels, but also try to bring the samples, soil samples, using these pneumatic pressure sondes in the soils, exactly in the area where we discovered the remains of the dwelling or other archaeological important things. And we can understand the structure or the stratigraphy of the site before the excavation. So now we are preparing the small excavation during the May, and probably we'll know more, we'll get more information about the dwellings and other artifacts. So this is the full picture of the Putinerstein done last year. This is pipeline, so it's not archaeological remains, but most of the sites, most of the dwelling and construction are placed in this area. So we got, and finally we got the results which encouraging us to use these magnetometers in the late antiquity sites too, which are very important for us. So you probably know this Santana de Muris Chernihov culture, this German local culture, which is very attractive, spread in the eastern part of Europe. Just another picture of the magnetometer. So the site which we are working last year, it's medieval, late medieval site. It's Soroca Fortress or the Soroca Castle from 15th, 16th century in the northern Republic of Moldova. And because the cross-border project together of Ukraine and Romania, rehabilitation of the medieval fortresses, we tried to, okay, they invited us to do the archaeological surveys. And we try to use, again, the new methods, non-invasive methods, and some small excavations, of course. And first of all, we try to use these world maps and to understand the structure, because now around the fortress, it's a park done during the 50s, but without any plans, without any documentations, and now it's we cannot understand how it was done, how it was organized. The park, we try to place the world maps, and one interest was to discover the remains of the church. So medieval church mentioned in various written sources, but now we cannot see the remains, and we used, of course, different methods, GPR and GPS and magnetometer. In the area supposed where it is the remain of the church, we concentrated, we used the tools, and now you could see much better. So we supposed, according to the map, that it should be here, but in finally we didn't discover the remains of the church. We discovered the remains of the dwellings from Cucutien Tripole culture. Why? Now we could suppose no medieval or modern layers, no medieval stratigraphy. It's exactly coming to direct to the prehistoric stratigraphy. Probably during the Soviet times, when the Soviet administration organized the park, probably they cleaned the area until the prehistoric, because nothing on stratigraphy, and we just got directly to the prehistoric site, or the map is wrong and the church it's another part of the site. So we'll continue to do the surveys around the fortress, and who knows, maybe next year we'll discover this church, because we know exactly that it was demolished at the beginning of 19th century as a result of different earthquake, and it was damaged, and they tried to clean the area and to build another church not so far from previous one. But unfortunately we didn't discover this methods, and we will try to use. So we published the results in our conference proceeding book, and of course it's accessible. You could get the online access to the work and to see different approaches to the recovering the history and archaeology of medieval castle Soroka. That's all.
Thank you very much indeed.